Hi, welcome back. It's time to get this project well and truly wrapped up and onto new things. So I'm up for an overnight again, which leaves me with a full day on this tomorrow. So what have we got to do? We've got to finish off a couple of the small sleepers at the far end, which we didn't get around to last time. I'm gonna cut the spare couple of sleepers we've got left to fit there. And I've picked up some half sleepers. I haven't used these before, but they're really nice sturdy boards. They are 50 mil thick rather than 100 mil. Supposedly these are just landscape grade again, but these look really, really smart. Tempting to actually get a few and dry them in the workshop because I'm pretty sure this stuff would plane down really nicely after a year or so of drying. Got some fence posts and some gravel board just to make our little screen for where the trailer's gonna go. And then unfortunately a load more plastic bags. It's cheaper to buy it this way than getting dumpy bags delivered off the truck. So, and like I've mentioned before, the entrance here is a bit tight. Now I was gonna buy bagged mulch like the compost and just bring it in, but he had a couple of these bags which had just been sat in the yard for a year or so, but absolutely perfect for what I need. And I think they were 40 quid for a ton bag and a half, so it's pretty good. So that's gonna be our ground cover. Anyway, enough chat. I'll go and get my work gear on, we'll unpack, and then we'll get to work on the gravel and drainage. One of the jobs which we kind of added on was just to replace all the panels behind, just because they were going to look pretty ropey behind, and they've been up there I think he said 20 years, so they've lasted pretty well. I'm hoping it's going to be the easy job out of the whole lot and it's just a case of slotting them out, slotting them in, but nothing is ever quite that easy, so we'll have to wait and see. That's the fence panels, next the timber. Now we're left with the bolt bags. Bolt bags are one of those things that you think, oh, I can shift that. I think this one's probably quite light. I'm a bit worried that the other one I'm gonna have to dig out of the van. I try dragging it, but I can see it tipping. Aha, why don't we use that oak? Build ourselves a ramp. Okay, so I'm gonna make a start this end. There's quite a bit to fill here, so I'm expecting that I'll use up all six bags of the compost, dig it in with the soil, and then I'll head out and get some more for that end. What I need to do though is build up the gravel against the sleepers and the soil, or the compost, at the same time, just so we can create a vertical wall with our membrane behind. So obviously if we throw the gravel in now, it'll just pool at the bottom. So we kind of want to backfill it with the soil first. See a problem. Because the wall curves around that way and we've tied in the fabric between the concrete, we've ended up creating like an envelope. I can't pull back the fabric all the way because it's pinned over there. So I'm going to need to just feed the soil underneath it and pack it across, I think. Otherwise I'm going to have to cut the fabric. Well, if there was any doubt whether the fabric sandwiched in the concrete would work, it does. The concrete has gone solid and encapsulated it. So I'm definitely going to have to cut that in. And hopefully, by the time we get to here, we should be all right. And that's left us with about 3 or 4 inches of drainage, which is plenty. So we're just going to lift this up, pour the gravel in. Okay, I've got most of this done now, in that I've got the soil level just about where I want it. I've backfilled with the gravel, so drainage is sorted, but I still want to build up a little bit of the soil this end, and down the other end I'm quite short, so I'm going to go and grab a few more bags, a couple bags of gravel, and I think that's it, some screws for the fencing, and that'll be it for the day, and then we'll pick this up tomorrow. Okay, another day, another morning. And hopefully today is going to see it all finished. Last night I managed to pick up all the remaining bits and bobs that we needed, and under the moonlight, or when it was getting pretty dark, I unloaded those, so I've got everything set up in little stations, ready to get going. I was a little short on weed fabric, so quick Amazon Prime to get another little section delivered. That should be here in about an hour or two, which means I can definitely finish that. So I thought I'd give you one more look at this drainage setup, because it's one of the most commonly asked things on the channel, or hotly debated things when you're dealing with timber in gardens, whether it's fence posts or whatever. Now, yes, I've sunk them down to the concrete, but we've made sure that we've got drainage at the bottom. The concrete slopes away from the oak. It's oak as well, so it is more durable, but we've prevented any of the soil touching the timbers. So like I showed you yesterday, this gravel goes all the way down to where the concrete starts, and we've got maybe 100 mil of that, actually slightly more at the bottom. Then the fabric comes up vertically and then goes across over our soil. So one, any water that heads this way can drain straight down. It'll either drain backwards off the concrete, or it'll make its way through the slots in the timbers. And also we've got this completely weed-proof membrane, so that nothing's gonna grow up through this. So it's kind of serving two purposes. Personally, I think it's just one thing you don't wanna scrimp on. You don't wanna rush the, you know, you're gonna spend all that money and time building a timber wall. The last thing you wanna do is just rush the finishing stages so that it you know, ends up rotting. So this gravel is a simple way to do it. If it was a taller bed, then you could use a drain, like a slotted drain behind there, but this should be ample. So what I'm thinking we'll do first is finish this side of the project, or the whole of the raised bed. Then I can look at the smaller section once that weed fabric, the landscaping fabric arrives. But one of the other jobs to do is that little parking spot for the trailer. I've managed to get the slabs down now for the parking area for that trailer. Now they were a mixture of paving from over the years, I think. Some were 600 wide, some were 2 foot, some were inch and a half type thickness, some were 2 inches, it was like metric and imperial. But anyway, it's all down now, so that's a solid base for the trailer. I'm not gonna get around to doing that little fence around it, I don't think. I'd rather get the main borders finished. So we're gonna take a look at that. First of all, I'm going to get those fence panels in because that appears to be quite an easy, straightforward, quick job. And I think that's what I need. So that's pretty easy. Next job, slide the new ones back in. Although I have spotted there's a cheeky small one in the middle. We'll have to cut one down. But the rest of them can go straight back in. Finishing off this end with some of this half-width sleeper. It's 50mm thick, so, and it's just lovely to work with because it's much more manageable. I'll cut it in one pass, just about. But I'd be quite confident building raised beds with this stuff. It's absolutely solid, it's oak, and it's almost a better quality, although it comes from the same batch. There's less wany edge. I mean, it's pretty much like a board you'd see air dried for use in a joinery. I'm sure the grade isn't quite as good, but anyway, so I'm going to cut this one. A bit of an angle on this end to cut. And then that's ready to backfill with the gravel. That's just lovely. And of course, it's much easier to get a nice square finish because you're not coming at it from both ends like you are with the thicker sleepers. think we're just about there. I've had a good tidy up. Of course there's no plants in yet, so it looks rather brown. But the structure's there, everything's nice and neat and tidy. And it's nice to leave it that way. So I'll give you a quick look around. You can have a look at a bit of the detail of how I've finished off the end there. And how you can't see the gravel anymore, so it's all kind of all bark right to the edge. And then we'll wrap it up. So if I could have got a slightly bigger delivery of soil, I might have brought it up a little bit higher, but it's good to keep it down a little bit behind these sleepers just so nothing starts spilling over. But it's still close enough that you could grow something and kind of train it to drape over the front there. But I haven't skimped on the bark, and I think the worst thing you can do if you're using this weed fabric is just put a little skinny layer, because it soon disperses and you get bare patches and it just looks rubbish. So that's why I've tried to keep things as flat as possible. There's a little bit of up and down undulation, but fairly flat, and I've given it a good sort of 100 mil, which sounds overkill, but actually you don't have to do half as much watering. It's definitely going to suppress even any weeds that might make their way up through it. And it just means we're not going to have any bare patches if it starts kind of blowing around. And also by going for the finer chip, the wind doesn't blow it around. Some of the bigger stuff curls up, becomes really lightweight, and that's kind of what causes it to blow off. Still got the pointing to finish down here, and that's important because I don't want the weeds growing in through those bricks. So we'll get that up. Well, next time we happen to be up here, I'll finish that bit. So the little trailer park that I've built is almost finished. I've put these down, just a little compacted base, sub base, and then these are just down on a sharp sand mortar. They're absolutely fine, they're going nowhere. They're really thick, sort of commercial grade slabs. Unfortunately, some are 600 square, some are 2 foot square. So there's a little staggered join there, but only I would have spotted that. And then I've tried my best with that angle grinder to cut the curve. Remember, we've got the screen, the wooden screen, and we up to here, like a little fence to shield the view of the trailer. So the curve's just to help with mowing and just so it kind of tidies it all up. So when I get a chance, when it's all planted up and when it really is finished, I'll bring you up for a final tour just to kind of give you a real idea of what it's going to look like. But everything's gone to plan. It was a 4-day build. They were long days, so probably 5 normal days. But single-handedly, I think we managed. We didn't have the mini digger, and we did everything by hand as far as the deliveries. So it could have been made a little bit easier, and it certainly would be easier if you had a couple of people with you. But hopefully it's inspired you to try something like it yourself. If you enjoyed the build, give us a thumbs up. I'll stick some more oak sleeper type landscaping projects at the end of the video. And remember, if you can, do it yourself, and we'll see you next time.